you all, yes, I know that you all will be fine. Okay, today let us start the new lesson, that is HCF and LCM. Okay, the new lesson is HCF and LCM. What is meant by HCF and LCM? HCF means it is highest common factor, and LCM means it is lowest common multiple. Before we learn about HCF and LCM, we will learn some of the concepts, that is types of divisibility. Okay, before learning HCF and LCM, you need to know some of the divisibility tests. Let us see some of the divisibility tests. Okay, students. Yes. So here are some types of divisibility, that is how we can identify easily that the number is divisible by the other numbers. Okay? Yes. So these are the types of divisibility. Okay, we can see here which numbers are divisible by the other numbers. To solve problems, which is so much helpful. Okay, easily within a less time you can identify the numbers, okay, which are divisible. So see here, a number, any number is divisible by 2 if the last digit is 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8. So any number, if it is divisible by 2, then it should end with 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. In other words, we can say that the number is divisible by 2 if the last digit. Last digit means it is ones place. If the ones place is 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8, means those numbers are divisible by 2. Okay? Here, there are some of the examples. See here, 12. It is a even number and it is ending with 2. So, it is 12, here the last digit, that is ones place is 2. Therefore, 12 is divisible by 2. Understood? Then, 15. Here, the number is ending, here the last digit is 0. Or, in a ones place, there is a 0. Right, student? So, 50 is divisible by 2. Next, look here, 374. What is the last digit here? It is 4. Or we can say that 374. Here it is ending with the number 4. Or last digit is 4. Or in a ones place there is a 4. Okay? So this 4 is divisible by 2. Okay? So 374. This full number is divisible by 2. Okay, students? Next, look here. What is this number? 2708. Here, the last digit is 8. So 2708. This full number is divisible by 2. Okay, 2708. Here the last digit is 8. Therefore, it is divisible by 2. Because the number which end with 0, 2, 4, 6, 8 are divisible by 2. Here, what is this number? 946. So, here, what is the last digit? Or, which number is there in 1's place? 6 is there. So, this 946 is divisible by 2. Any other number you can take. Okay? Any other number you can take. Not only this. So, all these examples, if you see, it is ending with 2, 0, 4, 8, 6. Okay? So, that whole number is divisible by 2. So, if the last digit is 0, 2, 4, 6, 8, then that number is divisible by 2. Okay? Understood? Yes. So, the number which will be having even numbers, that is 0, 2, 4, 6, 8 in its 1's place or in the last digit, then those numbers are divisible by 2. Okay? 12, 50, 374, 2708 and 946 and any other number you can take. Okay? Which ends with 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. Hope you have understood. The numbers which ends with 0, 2, 4, 6, 8 are divisible by 2. Okay? Next. 5. So, when the number is divisible by 5, see here, is a rule. If the last digit is 0 or 5, so the number is divisible by 5 when its last digit is 0 or 5. Okay? Any number, if it is ending with 0 or 5, then we can decide that it is divisible by 5. The given number is divisible by 5. So, look at the examples. 10. Here the last digit is 0. So, 10 is divisible by 5. Okay? Then, 975. Here the last digit is 5. Or in 1's place there is 5. So, 975 is divisible by 5. Okay? Next, 4185. Here, last digit is 5. Okay? Or there is 5 in 1's place. Therefore, 4185 is divisible by 5. I hope it is also clear to you. The numbers which ends with 0 or 5 are divisible by 5. Any number, if it is ending with 0, then it is divisible by 5. Also, if any number, if it is ending with 5, then we can consider that whole number is divisible by 5. The numbers are divisible by 5 if the last two digits, last digit is 0 or 5. Yes. Next, divisibility test for 10. When the number is divisible by 10, the number is divisible by 10 when the last digit is 0. Okay? The number is divisible by 10 when the last digit is 0. Last digit means the number which is there in 1's place. See, I have written some of the examples. 17, it is ending with 0. So, 70 is divisible by 10. Okay, then 120. 120, it's ending with 0. Or the last digit is 0. Or 0 is there in a ones place. Ones place contains a 0. So 120 is divisible by 10. Then 5000. So here also, what is the last digit? Only last digit you have to see. Okay, last digit is 0. So 5000 is divisible by 10. Okay, so the numbers which ends with 0 are divisible by 10. Okay, yes. Next, divisibility test for 3. When the number is divisible by 3, look here. If the sum of the digits is divisible by 3, what is meant by that? Any number. Okay, consider any number. That is 39 I have taken here. So 39, we have to add these digits. So 39, it is what? It is 3 plus 9. 39, we have to write it as 3 plus 9. So we have to add the digits. 3 plus 9, that's equal to how much? 3 plus 9 equal to 12. Right? Now, 12 is divisible by 3. Right? 12 is divisible by 3. Therefore, 39 also is divisible by 3. Right, students? 12 divided by 3 equal to 4. Or 3 fours are 12. There is 12 in 3 ones are table. Right? So, 39, we have to add it, that is 3 plus 9. We have to add the digits. 3 plus 9, that's equal to 12. 12 is divisible by 3. Therefore, 39 is also divisible by 3. Okay? Yes. Next, I have taken the another example, that is 870. So, add these digits also, that is 8 plus 7 plus 0. 8 plus 7 plus 0. Here also 8, 7, 0 is there. Those digits we have to add. If there is a 4 digit also, like that only, 4 digits also you have to add. When you add 8 plus 7, how much it is? 15, right? 15 plus 0 is 15, right? Now, 15 is divisible by 3, right? 15 is divisible by 3. Therefore, we can say that 870 is also divisible by 3, right? So, 15 divided by 3 equal to 5. 3 5s are 15. There is 15 in 3 ones are table. Okay? So, 870 is also divisible by 3. So, if the sum of the digits are divisible by 3, then the given number is also divisible by 3. If the sum of the given digits are divisible by 3 means the given number is also divisible by 3. Okay? Yes. Any number is given, you have to add it. See. Then you will get one answer. If that number is divisible by 3, the given number is also divisible by 3. Okay? Shall we move to the next number? So, next number is 9. Okay? Yes. So, here also same rule what we have followed in the 3, here also same rule. If the sum of the digits is divisible by 9, if the sum of the digit is divisible by 9, then the given number is also divisible by 9. See, I have written some of the example, that is 27 I wrote. Sum of the digits, we have to add this, 2 plus 7, that's equal to 9, right? 2 plus 7 equal to 9. Is 9 is divisible by 9? Yes. 9 divided by 9 equal to 1. So 9 divides the 9 exactly. Okay. So 9 is divisible by 9. Therefore 27 is also divisible by 9. Understood? If the sum of the digits are divisible by 9, then the given number is also divisible by 9. Next example, look here, 4257 I have taken. Now we have to see that whether it is divisible by 9. How we can do it easily? So we have to add all these digits, that is 4 plus 2 plus 5 plus 7. You can see here I have written the same number, 4 plus 2 plus 5 plus 7. How much you will get? 4 plus 2 6, 6 plus 5 11, 11 plus 7 it is 18. Is 18 is divisible by 9? Is there 18 in 9 ones are 12? Yes. So 9 twos are 18. Therefore 18 is exactly divisible by 9. 18 is divisible by 9. 18 is divisible by 9. Therefore 4257 is also divisible by 9. So here 18 divided by 9 equal to 2. Okay, 9 times are 18, or 2 nines are 18. Understood? Divisibility test for 3 and 9 are same. Okay, here the number should be divisible by 3, here the number should be divisible by 9. Okay, only that is the difference. So we have to add the given number, their digits we have to add, then we will get an answer. If that number is divisible by 9, the given number is also divisible by that number. Yes. Next, divisibility test for 4. How we can decide that the given numbers are divisible by 4 when the big numbers are given? That is, if the last 2 digits are 0 or last 2 digits are divisible by 4. When it is a small number, we can understand. When it is a big number, we cannot understand. So that we can use this rule. If the given number, if the last 2 digits means the numbers which are there in 1s and 10s place, if it is 0, then the given number is divisible by 4. That is one. Then one more thing is that if the last 2 digits, that is the number which are there in 1s and 10s place, are divisible by 4, then the given number, full number, is divisible by 4. Here there are two rules, that it is, if the last 2 digits are 0, then that number is divisible by 4. If the last 2 digits are divisible by 4, then also the given whole number will be divisible by 4. Okay, look here, the example, 332. Okay, 332. Whether it is divisible by 4, how to say? So here observe the last two digit, that is the numbers which are there in ones and tens place. So is there 32 in 4 ones are table? Is there 32? 4 ones are 4, 8s are 32, right? 4, 8s are 32. Therefore, 32 divided by 4 equal to 8. So, the number 32 is divisible by 4 exactly. Okay? So, 4 8s are 32. Or 32 is divisible by 4. 32 is divisible by 4. Therefore, 332 is divisible by 4. Okay? Okay? Yes. Next, the number is 6048. Whether it is divisible by 4, how can we say easily? So, we have to observe the last two digits, that is the numbers which are there in ones and tens place. What is there in ones and tens place? It is 48. Whether 48 is divisible by 4? Yes. 4 ones are 4 here. 4 ones are 4. 4 twos are 8. Right? 12 divided by 1 equal to 12. So, 48 is divisible by 4. Okay? Or else we can say that 4 twelves are 48. Right? 4 twelves are 48. So, 48 is divisible by 4. Therefore, this full number 6048 is divisible by 4. Understood? Observe the last two digits. Then, here, what is this 700? Is it divisible by 4? Yes. Why? Because here the last two digits are 0. Okay? Last two digits also must be 0 only. Okay? Two digits also. The number which is there in ones and tens place. So you can consider the last two digits. Here 700. Your last two digits are 0. Therefore we can decide that the 700 is divisible by 4. Then 12 is divisible by 4? Yes. 12 divided by 4 gives us 3. Right? Because in 4 ones are table, there is an exact number 12. 4 how is that 12? 4 3s are 12. 12 divided by 4 when you do, you will get 3. Right? So, 12 is also divisible by 4. Okay? When only two digits are there, it is easy to divide. When it is like this big numbers are there, you have to consider the last two digits and you have to decide so that it will become easy. Now, next, 8000. Whether it is divisible by 4? Yes. Right? Why? Because here the last two digits are 0. The number which are there in ones and tens place are 0. Okay? So, 8000 is also divisible by 4. So, the number is divisible by 4 if the last two digits are 0, one thing, then if the last two digits are divisible by 4. Okay? Yes. Next, one more, that is 6. This is very easy. That is, when the given number is divisible by 6, if the number is divisible by both 2 and 3, if the given number, suppose any one number is there, that number should divide by 2 also and 3 also. By both the number you should divisible. Then only the given number is divisible by 6. If it is divisible by 2 and if it is not divisible by 3, it is not divisible by 6. Okay, it should be divisible by both 2 and 3. If it is divisible by 3 and if it is not divisible by 2, then that number is not divisible by 6. Okay, so what are the examples? That is 6. Is 6 is divisible by 2? Yes, 2 3s are 6. Therefore, 6 divided by 2 gives us 3. Right? Then, is 6 is divisible by 3? Yes, 3 how much are 6? 3 2s are 6. Therefore, the number 6 is divisible by both 3 and 2. Understood? Therefore, 6 is divisible by 6. Next, 324. 324. Is it divisible by 2? Yes. How you understood? Because 324. Observe the last digit. What it is? 4. Right? The numbers which ends with 0, 2, 4, 6, 8 are divisible by 2. Therefore, 324 is divisible by 2. Then, see that or check that 324 is divisible by 3. So, what we have to do for that? We have to add the given digits. Okay? 3 plus 2, 5. 5 plus 4, 9. Right? So, 9 divided by 3. Is 9 is divisible by 3? Yes. 3 how much are 9? 3. 3's are 9. Right? So, 324 is divisible by 2 and 3. Therefore, 324 is divisible by 6. Okay? Next, 150. This is also, is it divisible by 2? If so, why? Because here the number is ending with 0. Here the last digit is 0. Therefore, it is divisible by 2. Then check that whether it is divisible by 3. So, for that we have to add the digits. 1 plus 5, 6. 6 plus 0, 6. Whether 6 is divisible by 3? Yes. 6 divided by 3 equal to 2. Right? Therefore, the number 150 is divisible by both 2 and 3. Therefore, 150 is divisible by 6. Likewise, even 648. One more example I have taken. 648, that is divisible by 2. Why? Because here the last digit is 8. Then check that whether it is divisible by 3. That is 6 plus 4, 10. 10 plus 8. Okay? Can see here 648. Okay, that is 6 plus 4 plus 8. That's equal to 18. Is 18 is divisible by 3? Is there 18 in 3 ones are table? So 3 how much are 18? 3 ones are 3. 6 are, right? 6 divided by 1 equal to 6, right? So, 18 is divisible by 2 also and 18 is divisible by 3 also. Like that also we can consider. So, it is divisible by 2 and 3, both the numbers. So, the number 648 is divisible by 6. I hope you have understood the divisibility test, which is very much important to solve the problems. Okay, so you should know the divisibility test. Okay, the numbers which are ending with 0, 2, 4, 6, 8 are divisible by 2. The numbers which ends with 0 and 5, 0 or 5 are divisible by 5. A numbers which ends with 0 are divisible by 10. Then in the sum of the digits are divisible by 3, then the given number is divisible by 3. Then if the sum of the digits are divisible by 9, then the given number is divisible by 9. Then 4. If the last two digits are 0, the given number is divisible by 4. If the last two digits are divisible by 4, then the given full number is divisible by 4. Then 6. That is, if the given number is divisible by both 2 and 3, then the given number is divisible by 6. I hope you have understood. Thank you, students.